وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
What should we give to children below the age of puberty to study the religion, particularly if they haven't yet learned to read the Qur'an? Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen wa salatu wa salam ala abdillahi wa rasulih Nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. So children go through several phases, and we had mentioned this in the Muslim family course. Particularly here, we want to look at before and after tamyiz. Tamyiz is a stage in a child's life where the child becomes aware of what's right and what's wrong. So they haven't yet reached puberty, but they're at an age where they understand the difference between right and wrong. And so below that age, they don't really understand the difference between right and wrong. For example, if you take like a three-year-old child, for example, they don't have a developed understanding of right and wrong. They might have a sort of a fitri understanding, a natural understanding that mom and dad shout at me when I do this or something like that. But a really sort of mature, developed understanding of right and wrong probably comes somewhere around the age of 5 years old, perhaps 6 years old. It depends on the child, sometimes maybe even 7 years old, but around that sort of age. Certainly by 7 years old, you would absolutely expect the child to have reached the age of tamyiz, and probably quite before that. Some children maybe 4 years old, some five, six, and so on. So here we need to distinguish between these different phases. And when the child reaches the age of tamyiz, it becomes easier in terms of educating them and supporting them to learn, because they're much more capable of understanding, even though they might not have the understanding of an adult, but they still have a developed understanding. Below that age, what are the things that you can do with your children before the age of tamyiz? So first of all, you can teach them knowledge that they have the ability to understand. For example, young children in nursery or kindergarten learn basic things like Allah is my Lord. They learn to read letters. They learn beneficial stories like stories from the seerah, stories of the prophets, and so on. So these are all things that, I mean, you can teach stories of the prophets to a two-year-old or a three-year-old. They won't have the same understanding and the same sort of be able to take as much out of it as a child who's reached the age of tamyiz, but at the same time, they will be able to benefit from it. And just like children in nursery and kindergarten, they learn, for example, the alphabet. So likewise, many children would be able to learn the Arabic alphabet. Many would be able to learn some Arabic, basic Arabic words for things. These are all things that you can teach a child before the child really understands in great detail. The second thing you can do is teach them positive habits. So it could be eating with the right hand. It could be saying Bismillah. It could be reading the Qur'an, or even just sitting with mom and dad when they read the Qur'an, you know, listening to the Qur'an. I remember asking my Qur'an teacher about my son at the time, who was younger than 5 years old. And he was not mumayyiz. He was not at the age where he knew the difference between right and wrong. And I asked the sheikh that would we be able to bring him to the sheikh to learn Qur'an, or at what age. And the sheikh said, he's a little bit too young at the moment, but what I would recommend for you to do is to get him into the habit of listening to Juz Amma, for example. So the sheikh recommended for me that I play Juz Amma to him regularly and read it to him regularly. And he said that as soon as, you know, once he's ready for that teaching, it's a little bit older, that you'll find that he's almost memorized it already from just that, just developing that positive habit with the child and developing letting them memorize things that they have the ability to memorize. And it might just be a small dua, a small word, alhamdulillah. It might be a small etiquette, but they still have the ability to memorize. And so I would say within these three things, teach them the knowledge they have the ability to understand, teach them positive habits, and also allow them to memorize. I've seen three-year-old, four-year-old children memorizing books of hadith. Not every child would be able to do that, but children are certainly able to memorize things at a young age. Depending on the child, you have to look at that. But look in those three areas. Look at knowledge. They do have the ability to understand, whether it's stories of the prophets, whether it's a very, very simple tafsir, whether it's, you know, very simple aqidah, like Allah is my Lord, you know, where is Allah? Allah is above the heavens. Very simple ideas and simple concepts taught in a very easy to understand way, positive habits, and whatever they're able to memorize that is easy for them to memorize. The main thing is that we need to adjust their learning according to their ability. And we shouldn't give them bad habits by exposing them to haram and saying that, oh, they're only little, when they're older, they will learn. We have to start these positive habits at a very, very young age so that those habits continue. And just like if you were asked the question, why do you teach, for example, your children not to lie at the age of 3 years old or 4 years old? Why do you teach them that when they're not accountable for their actions until puberty? Of course, from the point of view of a parent, you're blameworthy for teaching them haram. But why don't you? What's the concern for them? The parent, most people would say naturally, I'm concerned that they will develop the habit of lying. So likewise, if you nourish them upon the haram when they are younger, be it television, music, haram games or whatever, when they are younger, then the danger is that when they're older, they won't be able to leave that habit. Apart from the danger of the sin that you as a parent get for actually doing that in the first place. So it is important that you expose them to good things and you just adjust it according to their ability. And Allah Azza wa Jalla knows best.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.